children. Now this is 6th class social studies, the 7th lesson, Emergence of Kingdoms and Republics. What is that? Emergence of Kingdoms and Republics. Actually children, these kingdoms established in our country 2700 years ago. That means BC. Okay children, look at Ganges Valley 2700 years. Actually, we have many rivers in India. Some rivers are Himalayan rivers. Some rivers are peninsular rivers. What are the Himalayan rivers and their tributaries? Important rivers are three. Indus River, Ganga River and Brahmaputra River. What are they? Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. Indus River has five tributaries children. How many? Five tributaries. What are the five tributaries? Ravi, Jhelum, Sutlej, Bias. Okay. Ravi, Jhelum, Sutlej, Bias and another one. Okay children. So these five tributaries flowing through Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab, Chandigarh and also they will enter into Pakistan. Now at present that is separate country. But on those days, that means before independence, that is also one of the important parcel of our country. Okay. So here Indus River flowing that side. Next one, Ganga River. This Ganga River flowing Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Bangladesh, etc. Children. Okay, children? Etc. Okay. So, in this area, by the bringing of silt, this all area became very fertile. So, that is why in this area, 2700 years ago, some civilization or some kingdoms flourished, children. That kingdoms are called Mahajanapadas. What they are called? Mahajanapadas. Next one, look at here, cities and their administration. Here, kingdoms also there, Ganasanghas also there. Okay children, kingdoms, Ganasanghas. So the administration of the cities. So who will administrate? I said in the previous classes about who are Raja. Okay. And how they will rule the country. How they will collect the tax. Who are the responsible person to collect the tax in village level. How artisans, craft persons, farmers will give tax to the Grihapati. How Grihapati submit or send his tax to king, etc. Okay children. So here Mahajanapadas are 12 children. What are the 12? I read to you already, I wrote here. Kamboja. What is that? Kamboja, Gandhara. At present they are in Pakistan. After this lesson I will show you in your textbook these all Mahajanapadas. So Kamboja, Gandhara. Next to third one is Kuru. Next to Panchala. Fifth one is Sorasena. What is the fifth one? Sorasena. Sixth one is Matsya. Seventh Vatsa. Eighth Chedi. Ninth Magadha. Magadha is powerful kingdom. I said in the previous lesson, our previous class, Magadha kingdom is very powerful kingdom. Avanti, Anga, Asmaka. Asmaka kingdom is in our South India children. Look at Maharashtra, okay, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, So this area, 2700 years ago, they ruled in our South India by Asmaka. What? Asmaka. Now you keep in mind, children, Asmaka kings ruled our South India for. Okay? So these are the 12 Mahajanapadas in 2700 years ago ruled our country. Okay? Next, children, in this lesson, emergence of new thoughts and religion. Actually, I said about Vedic civilization. In that Vedic civilization, kings performed many rituals. They sacrificed many animals to gods. Okay, they worshipped some gods. Agni, Vayu, Astu, okay, Indra, etc., etc., gods. But what happened in this period? In this period, some prominent persons or some kings, they opposed the sacrification or sacrifice of animals. So thus animals are innocent animals. So that is why they are cut off the animals. That means they are killing the animals. They are killing the animals. Okay. In the form of worship of their gods. That means yagnas. They are performing yagnas. Okay, children. So after what happened, the people questioned who are performing these yagnas and yagas and sacrifice the animals. Okay, children. Actually, they said, we need not sacrifice any animals in the form of worshipping God, and also we need not perform rituals and yagnas, etc. So actually these yagnas and sacrification or sacrifice methods are very expensive, children. So the common people, they did not do, they were unable to do these all yagnas, yagas, etc. Why? Because it is burden to them. So how to reach God? What is the easy way? Okay, so here two religions also came into existence. What are the two religions? Jainism, codified by Mahavira. Whose children? Mahavira, Jainism. Second religion is here, it is also even today very famous in our country and also some other countries, Sri Lanka, Nepal, China, okay, Japan and some other countries, etc. Buddhism, children. So this Buddhism founded by Siddhartha. Who, children? Siddhartha. Next one, actually this Buddhism and Jainism, who founded? Siddhartha and Mahavira. They opposed the rituals. They explained to the people how to reach God. Okay, next one, they set some principles. How we will live upon the earth, how to help others, how to love others, how to respect others. Okay, children. So these all are telling by these, who? Siddhartha and Mahavira. So they founded this Buddhism by Siddhartha, Jainism by Mahavira. So Vedic rituals, I said already, so these Vedic rituals opposed by some people. For example, some kings are prominent persons, Siddhartha and Mahavira. Next one, other religions also there on those religions. What are the other religions? Look at Lokayata. This is one of the another religion. Next one, Ajivaka. It is also one of the another religion. Children, now what are the religions at present in our country? In our country, we know Hinduism, Buddhism, I said already about Buddhism. Jainism, I said already about Jainism. Next to Islam and Christianity. Okay, children? Sikh, etc. are there. Zoroastrianism also there, Confucianism. Okay, especially in our country, majority people are Hindus. Minority people are Buddhists, next to Islam, next to Christianity, etc. Okay, so these are the religions. So, what is the use of following religion? So here people believed, different people following and believing different religions. But the ultimate goal is to reach God after death. Okay children, to reach God after death. So how to reach God after death? In our living conditions, we need to change. Next one, we do not disturb other creatures. Next one, we do not kill others. We do not cheat others. We must to spend our life very holy, etc. Okay, children? So these all are advocating by some religions. What are the religions? At present we know Hinduism, Christianity, Islam, Buddhism, and etc. But on those days also, these two religions flourished, children. Okay, Lokayata and Ajivaka. So these are two, and Jainism and Buddhism, children. Okay, children. Next one, on those days, one art flourished. Gandhara School of Art, children. What is that? Gandhara School of Art. Actually, this art was flourished in Takshashila by the encouragement of Greek art children. Takshashila. Okay. Now, on those days, the people, they started sculpture. That means Vigrahalu Chakkadam. What is that? Vigrahalu Chakkadam. So, now we found many statues which is made by on those days people. Okay, for example, if you go to Amaravati, you can find one museum. In that museum, many statues are there. Buddha statues are there. Mahavira statues are there. Flower. Many, many different kind of statues are there, which is made by stone. Okay, children? Marble stone. Okay, next children, we can find Gautama Buddha statue, okay, in Andhulis. So these are the art of Gandhara. What is that? Gandhara School of Art, children. Okay, children. Now, here in this lesson, we discussed about the history of 2700 years ago, Ganges Valley Civilization. So how many kingdoms were issued? I said they are called Mahajanapadas. Okay, here I wrote already, 12 kingdoms are there. Okay, I read you once again, Kamboja, Gandhara, Kuru, Panchala, Sorasena, Matsya, Vatsa, Chedi, Magadha, Avanti, Anga, Asmaka. Asmaka was our South India children. Okay, now I want to show you some pictures in this lesson. Now look at children. Buddha in Gandhara art. Look at children, this is statue. Next children, look at the second picture. Depictions of an ancient Indian warrior from Gandhara. What is that? So look at how the ancient warrior was. Now this is ancient warrior. He is Buddha. Okay children. Now look at children, here some glossary. Archaeology. What is the meaning of archaeology? The study of human activity through the recovery and analysis of material cultures. Gana, Ganarajyam. A group that has many members. Sangha, Sanghamu. Organization or association. Dighanikaya means a Buddhist scripture
that first of the five Nikaya in the Sutta Pitika, Majjhima Nikaya, a Buddhist scripture, the second the five Nikayas in the Sutta Pitika. Okay, children, this is your lesson. Thank you.